so much of the success of our company should fall on Steve's shoulders. He single-handedly grabbed the WWE by the throat, you know, and said, let's go.
I do what I want, when I want, and can't nobody stop me. And that's the bottom line, cause Stone Cold sits on.
I'm a big wrestling fan. You know, having a match with my brother in the yard was something I always wanted to do.
I remember I was watching World Class Championship Wrestling one night in my dorm, and I saw that there was a professional wrestler there in Dallas, Texas, named Gentleman Chris Adams, who was going to have a wrestling school. Decided to enroll.
Austin began his career wrestling at the USWA in Dallas, but soon got the call from the bigger promotion, WCW.
Then, like we all were at one time, Steve was green. Steve was in a big learning process in WCW.
I saw a guy that, just as he is today, was hungry for our business, hungry for knowledge, clearly wanted to be the best at what he does.
Stunning Steve Austin is by far the hottest athlete in WCW.
I remember I'd been at WCW for quite a while. I'd been the TV champion, and Flying Brian and I became a tag team.
Those guys had it. They were a great tag team. The sky was the limit for them.
And then when we became successful and weren't really designed to be successful, they decided to split us up.
WCW didn't have a clue how to market Austin. The people in our booking department didn't see Steve Austin for the commodity that he was.
After I got fired from WCW, you know, on the phone by Eric Bischoff, the phone rings and it's Paul Heyman. He goes, why don't you come down to ECW and go to work with us?
He came in, he was rightfully very bitter and angry with the way he'd been let go at WCW.
The politics in WCW.
No, baby, that's for somebody else. We're just going to keep you right where you're at right now.
Kept the biggest potential superstar in wrestling on the damn ground.
As a result of these features, Steve would have another chance at superstardom, as he soon was hired by the WWE. Once Austin got on the
ring, King of the Ring was the whole Steve Austin story. The very next night, we go to Raw, and there are hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of Austin 316 signs all over the building. When we saw those signs, I said right then, I said, Steve Austin is going to be a big deal. There was no way to tell how big he was going to be, but we knew he was going to be a big deal.
You talk about in your face. That is who Stone Cold is.
There was one match that stands out in my mind as being very important. The Bret Hart-Stone Cold feud culminated in a great WrestleMania match.
WrestleMania 13 with Bret the Hitman Hart in Chicago was probably the most important match of my career.
And really cemented Stone Cold as the guy in WWE.
Seen an athlete my whole career as tough as Steve Austin. That was absolutely amazing.
Although Stone Cold lost the match, he was rapidly becoming the most popular superstar in the WWE and had his sights set on some gold in the form of the Intercontinental Championship.
I remember rolling into Continental Airlines Arena. It was a sold-out pay-per-view, 20,000 people. I was wrestling Owen Hart for the Intercontinental Championship. That Intercontinental belt meant so much to me because so many great, great wrestlers have had that, and these are the guys that are getting ready for that world title. I remember we went into the pile driver deal. I picked him up, and then we reversed that. He picked me up. My head was about, I don't know, 6-8 inches below the bottom of his legs, and he jumped up and spiked me on the top of my head. That's called an axial load. And I remember being in front of 20,000 people, and I remember it just like a big gong went off.
Austin is hurt, and hurt badly.
After a while, I couldn't use my hands yet, but I could turn over and I could use my forearms to crawl. It took me a long time to straighten my knees to be able to crawl. It took about 3 referees to pull me to my feet. I remember holding that belt up. It was like, you know, the lights were on, but nobody was home.
Through hell or high water, he is the Intercontinental Champion. He can barely stand.
At that point, after the MRIs, X-rays, and visited by 3 or 4 doctors, you know, I was basically out of the ring for about 3 or 4 months.
Nobody really knew that he was injured at that point because he was always on the program. He was always getting in somebody's face. He was always doing something to cause some turmoil. And it just wasn't mentioned that here's a guy with a bad neck. He ended up becoming more popular than when he was wrestling.
He was the guy they wanted to see, and all of a sudden it was taken away from them. So they didn't get that satisfaction every week. But Steve was part of our show. He wanted to come back, but Vince McMahon would not allow him. And it was from the fan standpoint, like, how dare you take Stone Cold away from us?
Sit here and tell me to work within the system. You ain't the one sitting on your ass in the house like I am. I appreciate the fact that you and the World Wrestling Federation care. And I also appreciate the fact that, hell, you can kiss my ass.
Once that myself and Vince started feuding, we always had our hardcore wrestling fans, but this was a storyline which was so big, which crossed so many boundaries because the people always wanted to give their boss the what for and maybe punch him in the mouth or do whatever, you know, it takes to him, was the thing that everybody had to watch on a weekly basis.
Oh, hell yeah!
I couldn't wait to go to work on Monday because I knew that they were going to supply me with the greatest stuff to do with Vince, whether it was filling a Corvette full of semen.
What if it's a legend? It's being destroyed by the rattlesnake. No!
Driving a beer truck in the ring and squirting everybody down with beer.
Wait a minute! Stone Cold! Hit beer! Stone Cold with a beer bath!
Driving a Zamboni into the ring.
Austin's on a Zamboni! Woo! Oh yeah! Oh yeah!
They gave me the greatest playground that anybody's ever gotten in the business. And I loved and enjoyed every minute of it and made the most out of anything they gave me.
The McMahon-Austin rivalry got more eyeballs to tune into TV and sold more tickets, more pay-per-views than any other time in our business.
I have never heard an ovation as we are experiencing here for the Rattlesnake!
Stone Cold Steve Austin, who would then become the greatest single star in the history of our business, eclipsing Hogan by far, in terms of all sorts of sales and attendance and everything.
You couldn't go anywhere without seeing Stone Cold Steve Austin merchandise, and nobody before or since has had that kind of impact on the culture.
Steve Austin does what he wants.
Austin's raising hell!
What he wants.
It all ended up with me working with Shawn Michaels in WrestleMania 14. I was white hot at the time.
Stone Cold Steve Austin must overcome the greatest champion of all time.
Shawn was passing the torch over to Stone Cold Steve Austin, who was becoming the biggest thing in the business.
Austin, he got it! The Stunner! Mike Tyson in! Austin is the champion! Stone Cold! Stone Cold! Stone Cold!
It was a very special match for me being there and winning my first title.
The Austin era has begun!
You know, when you grow up watching professional wrestling like I did, and you just absolutely love it, and you love being on the road and love being in the ring, for you to get your first championship, it was just a real, real big deal and an honor that a company is going to jump on your back and, you know, feed you carrots, but you're going to be the horse pulling that wagon. You know, I was very honored.
The spectacular moments and matches that the 1990s will be remembered for were largely created by the superstars we just featured. Okay, let the debate begin about who's on the list, who's not on the list. But you know what? If you got a problem with it, just call my associate Joey Numbers. He stands by all of these selections. So look, at the end of the day, here's the deal. I'm Taz. Thanks for joining me looking back at the greatest stars of the 1990s.